Hello friends, in the previous video we've created pagination support for our blog, and with the help of p parameter we can browse through different pages of posts loaded from a database table. In order to add pagination support and render pages below our post list, I'm going to use existing blog and template. This template is located in a sim module. I'm going to add this blog into layout into post.phtml template, and this block will be Magento sim. So this is a Magento sim module block HTML pager. So this class includes all the logic for us to implement this pager, and it includes template, very well written version of pagination, and I don't see a reason why would I create my new one, unless I would like to practice creating pagination. But it's not the story with this lesson. We would like to add pagination support for our blog page. So I've added a blog. This blog will render a template, and I can reference this blog in my template by using this alias. So let's go to our post.phtml file, and let's use pager block get child block, and alias is block pager. So this should be block pager, should match what we've written in our layout file. And after for each, we are going to use if. We will check whether we have this block, because it could happen that we don't have it in our layout file. But if we do, I'm going to use a post view model, and I will create a method getPager. And we'll pass two arguments: collection that is going to be used for that block, pager block, and pager block. So that's a change in our template file. Let's go to view model, and let's add a method getPager. And here we have a dependency for collection and dependency for pager block. Let's import this dependency, and this will return string. So I'm going to prepare HTML, but not like I'm going to write HTML here. I'm going to prepare block to return HTML. So there is a list of methods that we need to call in order to prepare that block and before rendering to our post.phtml file. So this is setUseContainer. We're going to say false, setShowPerPage false. We are not interested in a number. SetShowAmounts false. Again, you can play with this methods and put true and see the difference, or if you require additional logic and HTML markup for pager, you can change this values to true and see additional markup. And set limit, we are going to use collection get page size, and finally we're going to set collection to be collection, and as a result we're going to return to HTML. This is a public method that is responsible for rendering what's in template and processing it and returning HTML that is a string, and as a result we will return it to our template, and template will render it on a page. I made a typo here, so let's correct. And as a result, we added pager to our blog page, so we can click different pages, we can navigate through these pages and show different posts from a database. I'm going to post source code of this video on my free course that you can find on imagemastery.net website. So make sure to check this website. And in the next video, we are going to create postcards on a blog page so we can see more than just a title. So make sure to subscribe to this channel if you would like to continue watching such videos, and click like below this video, and I will see you in my next video.